Researchers at UC San Diego have been scanning the brains of a group of young people for more than 10 years. 24-year-old Tim Little has been involved since the beginning.
Actually, a friend of mine got me in this study. He came upon a flyer at the corner by Del Taco in Claremont and said, hey, listen, they're doing brain scans and brain imaging, and they pay us a couple $100. Do you want to check it out? And when we were kids, like 13 or something, so I was like, yeah, hopped on in it.
Once a year since he was 13, Little has gotten his brain scanned at UC San Diego.
This room contains the MRI scanner. It's just like those you'll find in a hospital, except this one allows more refined, more detailed images.
While their brains are being scanned, study participants are asked to solve puzzles, complete simple tasks, and answer questions. This study focused on 40 young people. Their brains were first scanned when they were 12 to 14 years old, prior to the onset of drinking. Researchers scanned them again 3 years later and found some surprising results when they looked back at the original scans.
The kids who later were going to start drinking showed less brain activation in some frontal and parietal areas as they were doing the task. They did okay on the task, but this maybe shows that they weren't as fully engaged in the task as the kids who were going to get through adolescence without starting to drink heavily.
Tapert explains as kids go through adolescence, their brains generally become more efficient. In other words, their brains don't require as much neural energy to accomplish a given cognitive task. But she says for the kids who later started to drink heavily, their brains worked harder to accomplish the same task.
Well, that there is some kind of something that we need to take note of about these activation patterns prior to the onset of substance use that might be linked to some kind of feature related to maybe self-control, propensity for intoxication, other risk-taking propensities.
Dr. Mark Schuchat has been studying alcoholism for more than 30 years. His research focuses on how genetics and environmental factors influence heavy drinking and other substance abuse. Schuchat says Dr. Tapert's study suggests there may be patterns in adolescent brains that indicate the likelihood of future alcohol abuse. But he says that doesn't mean doctors could tell someone they're going to be an alcoholic by the time they're 25.
But I can do, I think, and what people in our field can look forward to, is I can say to you, you are carrying an increased risk for diabetes or for alcoholism. And regarding that risk, it appears that it operates through this particular characteristic. Perhaps impulsivity related to some of the risk, perhaps low sensitivity to alcohol for others. And then I can say, considering the fact that you are carrying the risk related to that particular factor, I think I can work with you, if you're willing to try to help you diminish your risk.
Researchers haven't told Tim Little whether his early brain scans showed any unusual patterns. As it turned out, he did drink when he was in high school, heavily at times. These days, Little says he'll have a beer every now and then. And if it turns out Little has a biological propensity for alcoholism?
Shoot, I'd have to make a whole lifestyle change. If that was the case, I'd have to give it up. I'd have to focus on being healthy, try to make the best of what cards I got dealt. If that's the case, obviously changes have to be made.